Welcome to all in basics of MATLAB programming. In today's video, we are going to learn how to merge multiple matrix in MATLAB. For this, I am considering two problems. First one, in which we are going to merge identical size matrix, and second one is in which I am going to merge non-identical size matrix. Starting with first problem. In first problem, suppose we have 4 2x2 matrix. We can merge these 4 matrix as a single matrix of 4x4 order, in which first 4 elements are of matrix A, second 4 elements are of matrix B, and third 4 elements are of matrix C, and last 4 elements are of matrix D. To get this matrix, we have used a simple method in which a matrix E has been generated by considering A, B, C, D as 4 elements of matrix E. In second problem, suppose we have 4 matrix in which first one is of 2x3 order, second one matrix is of 4x1 order, and third one matrix is of 2x2 order, and fourth matrix of 2x1 order. In this, all the 4 matrix are not identical in size. So how to merge these 4 matrix? We can merge these 4 matrix like this 4 matrix, 4x4 order matrix, in which all the 4 matrix are as shown is here. We can achieve this matrix by a simple method, little bit different one from the previous one. In this, we are calling single element individually and placing them as shown in the given figure. That is, A is placed here, B is placed here, C is placed here, and D is placed here. So now friends, let me start with MATLAB. First of all, open new script file. So starting with the first command, that is for loading MATLAB, loading matrix into MATLAB. Suppose we are copying all the matrix in variable A, B, C, and D. We can ask load this matrix by using command input enter any matrix of the order of 2x2 for first problem or 2x3 for second problem. Similarly, we can write the command for other 3 matrix also. Now our next step will be to get the size of or check the size of the matrix A, B, C, D which has been entered by the user. Size of the matrix. Suppose I am storing rows of A and column of A in RA and CA variable, for which we can get by command size A. This command giving the rows and column in the matrix A. Similarly, I can copy this command for B, C, D also. Now considering first problem, when input matrix are identical in size. In this case, we will check if RA is equal to RB and RA is equal to RC and RA is equal to RD. That means I am comparing that either all the rows in matrix A, B, C, D are equal or not. Along with that, I will also compare either all the columns are equal or not. That is, C A equal to C B and C A is equal to C C and C A is equal to C D. Here we will use not a single equal, is required is double equal, because error is showing that what error showing uses a single equal user might be invalid matrix. So here we will use double equal sign. Now if all the rows and all the columns are equal, then we can use our first method that we have given in previous slide. That was, we can consider A, B, C, D as single element of output matrix. Suppose output matrix is E, then we can simply write this command A, comma B, C and D. That means we are considering output matrix as containing A, B, C, D as single element of the matrix. Now considering second problem, in which when input matrix are non-identical in size. Now again we will check the size of row and column, and we will use command else if as input matrix is of 2 by 3 order. So we will check is it have two rows or three columns or not. So by this command we are checking its size, and this is 3. Similarly, matrix B of size 4 by 1, so RB is equal to 4 and CB is equal to 1, and matrix C of order 2 by 2, so RC is equal to 2 and RD is equal to 2. Sorry, RC, here will be C, C is equal to 2. At last we will take consider matrix D, RD is equal to 2 and CD is equal to 1, as D matrix is of 2 by 1 order. If this condition is satisfied, then we can use following method, that is, a matrix will be formed of the order 4 by 4, in which, or sorry, which has been denoted by matrix E, in which first two rows and first three columns, we are selecting this by, that is, first two columns, sorry, two rows and first three columns by matrix A, and replacing all the elements of rows of last column with matrix B. Similarly, elements of third and fourth row of third column is replacing or moving with element of matrix C, and at last third and fourth rows of third column by matrix D. In previous, sorry, mistake, it was third and fourth rows of first and second rows, sorry, columns of matrix E by matrix C. By this command we are performing or solving second problem in which non-identical size matrix has been considered. Now, if the user is entering the matrix with the other than the order which we have specified, so that means when the input matrix are of incorrect order, then we can display a plain message in which we can write following message: the order of input matrix is incorrect. You can display message according to your choice, whatever you want to show you can write here. And now you can end the program. Now save this program. According to your choice, and run this program. On command window, a message is blinking which is asking for matrix. First of all, I am entering matrix according to first problem in which all the matrix are of same size, so I am considering 2x2 matrix. Suppose first one matrix is 1 1, in which all the elements are of 1 and the order of matrix is 2x2. In similar way, second matrix is of all the elements containing elements 2x all the elements are 2, and third matrix containing elements 3, and fourth matrix containing element 4. So now check the output. Now you can see that you have the matrix of four order, in which first four elements are of matrix A, second four elements are of matrix B, third four elements are of matrix C, and last four elements are of matrix D. That means you are getting output according to your first problem. So now considering second case, so now again run the program and enter the matrix according to second problem. That is, first matrix is of the 2x3 order, second matrix is of the order of 4x1, and third matrix is of order 2x2, and last matrix are of order 2x1. Now again check the output. Now you can see that now you are getting 4x4 matrix, and the output is according to as we have discussed in our earlier slides. Now you can consider that suppose the user entering matrix not of first problem, not of second problem. So according to us, a message should be displayed. So let us check it. For that condition, again run the program and entering matrix which is not mentioned here. Suppose I am considering first matrix of 1 and second matrix of only 2's, and randomly I am selecting any matrix. And last matrix is this. So now you are getting the message: the order of the input matrix is correct. So this is sufficient for the problem which we have starting in our slides. Friends, if you find this video useful, so don't forget to like this video, subscribe our channel, and share this video. Thank you very much for being with us.